In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You are sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, grant us so to celebrate the mysteries of the Lord's Passion, that we may merit to receive your pardon. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Hear me, O islands. Listen, O distant peoples. The Lord called me from birth, from my mother's womb. He gave me my name. He made me a sharp-edged sword and concealed me in the shadow of his arm. He made me a polished arrow. In his quiver, he hid me. You are my servant, he said to me, Israel, through whom I show my glory. Though I thought I had toiled in vain and for nothing, uselessly spent my strength, yet my reward is with the Lord, my recompense is with my God. For now the Lord has spoken, who formed me as his servant from the womb, that Jacob might may be brought back to him, and Israel gathered to him. And I am made glorious in the sight of the Lord, and my God is now my strength. It is too little, he says, for you to be my servant, to raise up the tribes of Jacob and restore the survivors of Israel. I will make you a light to the nations, that my salvation may reach to the ends of the earth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I will sing of your salvation.
I will sing of your salvation.
In you, O Lord, I take refuge. Let me never be put to shame. In your justice, rescue me and deliver me. Incline your ear to me and save me.
I will sing to your salvation.
Be my rock of refuge, a stronghold to give me safety. For you are my rock and my fortress. O my God, rescue me from the hand of the wicked.
I will sing to your salvation.
For you are my hope, O Lord, my trust, O God, from my youth. On you I depend from birth. From my mother's womb, you are my strength.
I will sing to your salvation.
My mouth shall declare your justice, day by day, your salvation. O God, you have taught me from my youth. Until the present, I proclaim your wondrous deeds.
I will sing to your salvation.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory.
Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory.
Hail to you, our King, obedient to the Father. You were led to your crucifixion like a gentle lamb to the slaughter. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Reclining at table with his disciples, Jesus was deeply troubled and testified, "Amen, amen, I say to you, one of you will betray me." The disciples looked at one another at a loss as to whom he meant. One of his disciples, the one whom Jesus loved, was reclining at Jesus' side. So Simon Peter nodded to him to find out what he meant. He leaned back against Jesus' chest and said to him, "Master, who is it?" And Jesus answered, "It is the one to whom I hand the morsel after I have given it." So he dipped the morsel and took it in his hands and handed it to Judas, Simon, a son of Simon the Iscariot. After Judas took the morsel, Jesus entered him. So Jesus said to him, "What are you going to do? Whatever you're going to do, do it quickly." Now none of these reclining at table realized what he had said to him. Some thought that since Judas kept the money bag, Jesus had told him, "Buy what we need for the feast, or give something to the poor." So Judas took the morsel and left at once, and it was night. When he had left, Jesus said, "Now is the Son of Man glorified, and God is glorified in him. If God is glorified in him, God will also glorify him in himself, and he will glorify him at once. My children, I will be with you only a little while longer. Look for me. You will look for me, and as I told the Jews, where I go, you cannot come. So now I say it to you." Simon Peter said to him, "Master, where are you going?" And Jesus answered him, "Where I am going, you cannot follow me now, though you will follow me later." Peter said to him, "Master, why can I not follow you now? I will lay down my life for you." And Jesus answered, "Will you lay down your life for me? Amen, amen, I say to you, the cock will not crow before you deny me three times." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
There's a full letter from George Washington to his wife Martha, dated March 4th, 1797, and no, I was not there. It was written just hours before John Adams was sworn in to succeed Washington as President of the United States. Washington had been sorting through his papers, deciding which to keep and which ones to throw out. And he writes, "You can imagine my feelings as I reread Thomas Paine's last letter to me. He and I were once friends, and yet because I didn't think him qualified to become Postmaster General, he charged me with being treacherous." Jesus also knew the pain and sorrow of having a close friend turn against him. The question for us is, how do we cope with crushing disappointments like having a close friend turn against us? Psalm 41 says, "The one I trusted most, the one who shared my food, has turned against me." Let us pause now to offer our petitions to our Father. For an end to abortion and euthanasia throughout the world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for an end to this terrible scourge of the COVID-19 virus in our world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
This Mass is offered for all souls. For these intentions, let us continue to pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all members of the church, may Christ strengthen us as we share the good news of the gospel. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For leaders and those who carry responsibility for the welfare of others, may Jesus guide them in the ways of servant leadership. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are struggling or suffering, may God's loving presence with them bring consolation and comfort. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the times we are afraid to welcome life, may the Lord fill our hearts with confidence in his loving care and provide for every need. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our first responders, new military chaplains, those in military academies or in basic military training, may God grant them strength and peace of mind as they prepare for future emergency service and sacrifices for the safety and peace of our nation. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those gathered here, may God open our hearts more fully and increase our faith in him. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our faithful departed, including David White, for whom Our Lady of Grace candle burns this week, may he, through Our Lady's faithful intercession, now rejoice with the angels and saints for all eternity in God's heavenly kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our personal petitions, which we hold in the silence of our hearts, for all these, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty God, we ask to receive these prayers through your Son, Jesus Christ, as we bring them humbly before your throne. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Look favorably, O Lord, we pray, on these offerings of your family, and those you make partakers of these sacred gifts, grant a share in their fullness. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For the days of his saving passion and glorious resurrection are approaching, by which the pride of the ancient foe is vanquished, and the mystery of our redemption in Christ is celebrated. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. Holy, 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 holy Lord God of hosts,
heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord, Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." A mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Oscar, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation,
but deliver us from evil."
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom,
the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your word, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
In this moment, Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ.
Let us pray. Nourished by your saving gifts, we beseech your mercy, Lord, that by this same sacrament with which you have fed us in this present age, you may make us partaker of life eternal. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth. The Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Thanks be to God.